Corruption Watch has identified gaps in information shared by government around the procurement of COVID-19 vaccines. The anti-corruption body held a webinar on corruption and COVID-19 procurement earlier today. It also discussed regulatory compliance needed to build public trust if the program is to succeed. The webinar heard that more still needs to be known and that other information should already be available. For more on this, we're joined by Dr. Allison Anthony, who's a senior lecturer in the Faculty of Law at UNISA. Dr. Anthony, thank you so much for your time this afternoon. I mean, I can imagine the COVID-19 pandemic has highlighted many of the challenges that we've known about with regards to, public procurement in South Africa.
Yes, of course. Thanks for having me. So this morning in the webinar, we discussed many of those issues and they're open to the public. I mean, if we look at the reports from the Auditor General, both the first and second report and also media release published on the 9th of December 2020, we see that there have been significant instances of corruption, fraud, and instances where the procurement process wasn't adhered to. So that is the problem that we are having to deal with now.
What are some of the concerns? I mean, we have these procurement deals, but what are some of the underlying concerns, perhaps when it comes to the price paid, how the negotiation worked? What were some of the things that were discussed at this webinar regarding that procurement side?
So one of the main things that we discussed is actually the issue of transparency. And that's the main concern, I think, and that we discussed in the webinar today, the issue of transparency and trust of the citizenry, of the public in our government, the fact that we haven't had much information that's been made available to us, information that I'm referring to, for example, the procurement process. We know that it was an emergency procurement process, deviations were permitted, but we still need procurement information, like, for example, the tenderers who submitted bids, the content of those bids, and more importantly, even the content of the contracts that were actually concluded at the end of the day. Also, we highlighted issues around the AstraZeneca vaccine information that we haven't received, and also the Pfizer vaccine. But I'm sure that the link to this morning's webinar is on the Corruption Watch website for those of you that want to have a look at it.
What information should be disclosed by government at this point? And from a legal point of view, are they able to do so without, I suppose, compromising on the non-disclosure aspects of whatever contract they've signed?
Well, that is also an issue we discussed this morning, the fact whether a non-disclosure agreement is even legal, whether it's constitutional to sign such an agreement. So that issue is still sort of unresolved. And a lot of those issues we dealt with in the webinar as well. So you can go and have a look at that there. But some of the information is what I just mentioned, pricing, very important one, the fact that there's an allegation that we have been paying more than the European Union, which is something that I think government should definitely clear up for us, the exact pricing for all of the contracts, actually, in all of the vaccines. And not only the procurement of the vaccine, but what is also important is the procurement of everything around the vaccine, things such as the logistics, the storage, the transport, your PPE, everything that has been needed and still will be needed for the rollout of the vaccine.
One of the other issues that was brought up, perhaps maybe not at the webinar, although I am curious to know if that was highlighted as well, was the role of provinces in the vaccine procurement. Because we do know that a lot of the provinces have their own legislature, their own executive council. Did that come up as a concern as to how they would be able to roll out, or if they would be actually, getting their own vaccine procurement programs going?
Well, that's something that we discussed just very quickly, but legally they are permitted to do so. We have seen the Western Cape government has tried to do that as well. We don't have information about that, but it has been in the media, and the Premier has announced that the Western Cape would like to procure their vaccines alongside the national procurement as well. But it wasn't an issue exactly that we precisely that we discussed in the webinar this morning.
Yeah. In the concluding remarks, because I can imagine that public trust is going to be vital, especially as we move on from, inoculating healthcare providers to essential staff and then down to the general population. What do you think should be the next messaging from government regarding this entire procurement program?
So I think what we'd like to see is as much information as possible. We'd like to see be let in on the entire process. And it's not only just a matter of being let in. These are actually constitutional mandates. It's written in our constitution, things like transparency, fairness, openness, accountability. So these are really not giveaways that we'd be getting. You know, these are constitutional mandates that the government is bound to. So we'd like to see more information regarding the contracts that are being concluded and the terms of those contracts.
Dr. Anthony, let's leave it there. Thank you so much for your time. That is Dr. Allison Anthony, who's a senior lecturer at the Faculty of Law at UNISA.